faces, it's 6 o'clock, time for Family Feud. Now, here's your host, Grant Denyer.
Here on The Feud, where two families go head-to-head and answer some seriously simple questions. And you know what? If they get them right, they'll be in the running for $10,000 and maybe a brand-new car as well. So let's meet them now. First up, our carryover champion. You like the sound of that, don't you? Oh, yeah, car. Let's get that. On their third night from Victoria, it's the best family. Two very excited teams. It was a nail-biter last night. So you're feeling more confident or a little rattled after a close call last night?
Oh, I'm going to go with confident, you know.
Good.
Put it out there.
Go with that.
Probably stab me in the back later.
Remind Australia. Let's hope not. Who's on board your team?
Okay, so we've got my auntie Robin, my cousin Andrew, and his beautiful wife Karen.
Beautiful. Great to have you guys back and ready to take them up from New South Wales. They love the sound of the car and their name is the Scott family. I think it was that you, Diane, who went, oh, car, yeah, I'm in. I'm in. Nice.
It was.
So let's just say you're here to win.
We are here to win.
And you're not stopping until night five when it's car time.
Night five, car time.
Remind Australia, or introduce us to your family, I should say.
My mother-in-law to be, Diane.
Yes.
My brother-in-law to be, Anthony. Mm. And the leader of the opposition, contestant number four, my beautiful fiancée, Rachel.
This sounds like a family audition for you.
It is.
We surveyed 100 people and the top 7 answers are on the board. Name something you associate with a limousine. Dave.
A driver.
A driver has to drive a limousine. Yeah. Well done. Pass or play, mate.
Good play this game,
yeah, play.
Thank you very much.
Let's go. Diane, lovely to see you.
It's very nice to meet you.
You're pretty keen to play then. You're going, you'll give him these ones.
Yes.
Come on.
I'm in it to win it.
Show me the money, says Diane. Something you associate with a limousine.
I would associate a wedding.
Nice. Excellent. Beautiful. I'll do you too, thanks. Something you associate with a limousine, Anthony.
I would say a similar thing, like a formal.
Let's take a look. Which usually involves about 27 kids all chipping in about $1.50 to have a ride. Rachel?
No reflection on my personality, but champagne.
Champagne! Playing well so far, Dave?
Good team.
I should hope so. You handpicked them. Name something you associate with the limousine.
Stretch.
Ah, the
perhaps.
Big ones.
Diane,
this is looking real good for you guys right now. The best family over there are currently shaking in their boots.
Yeah, it shows.
Does that make you feel pretty good?
Oh, yes. We're out there.
Something you associate with a limousine?
I'm going to say hen's party.
A hen's party might need a limousine.
Oh.
It's only the first strike, though, Diane. Anthony?
I think maybe just the colour white. Most white limousines.
Oh, like a white limousine. Nice, classy white one. Oh, it's two strikes. The best family could steal.
Oh, they're huddling.
They are huddling down there.
Everybody's missed the obvious answer.
What is it?
Party!
Oh, you got it at a party?
Yes.
Oh! Everybody's missed the obvious answer, Grant. I'll show you how to play. Right. Karen.
I've never been in a limousine, but I reckon there'd be a sunroof and you just want to be hanging out.
Yeah, you do it in the movies when you go down the strip in Vegas. You hang out the top. I like that, Andrew.
Maybe at the movies and the famous people, the actors.
Famous people, actors. Ride in them.
Ride in them.
For a living, yeah. Robin.
Yeah, I agree with Andrew. Celebrities. Try to take a bit of a cruise in the limo.
Okie dokie. Carly, some wonderful options from the best family right now for you to choose.
Very good answers. I'm going to have to go with celebrities.
Celebrities for the steal. Let's see if it gets you there. Yeah! Thanks. Back in business. The last answer on the board. be rich to be in one, maybe. Look, if either family goes on to win for 5 nights in a row, you know what? Ain't a limo, even better. The all-new Mitsubishi Outlander. Now, this great-looking SUV, it offers CVT auto with paddle shift, hill start control, plus the unique Mitsubishi multi-communication system and rain-sensing wipers. Now, here's a question for everyone playing along at home. I want the top answer to this one. Name something hard to crack. The answer when we all come back right here on Family Feud. Best of luck. Are still playing for $10,000. Now, before the break, I asked, name something that's hard to crack, and the top answer was...
Yes!
Yep. Robin, Diane, let's play.
Hello, Robin.
Hello, Diane.
This is very formal, isn't it?
How are you?
Quite well.
Oh, lovely.
We're going to maybe catch up after the show.
Sure.
We surveyed 100 people, and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name something you associate with a cottage. Yes.
A garden.
Let's have a look. Diane.
The country.
The country. Country cottage is good. By 1 point, pass or play.
We'll play.
You're going to play? They're going to play. Let's go. Anthony.
Yes.
How did you get caught wagging school?
I decided to do it on the day that my mum was working on canteen. Yes, bad choice, sorry.
You idiot!
Yes, I was there.
So mum's going, obviously, oh, so he'll come through in a minute just to get his food. And you never showed up.
Yeah, I think it was the vice principal went and said, oh, how's your son doing? He must be sick today. And she's like, no. So, yes.
And were you on your own? Did you take
Oh, no, it was a whole bunch of us.
Oh, decided. So they all got in trouble because your mum was on canteen duty.
Yeah.
Well, I bet you were popular.
No.
Something you associate with the cottage?
A white picket fence.
Let's have a look. Yes.
Now we're talking.
All right.
Oh, my brother
What's
stole my
What's the most obvious answer here, Rachel?
Party!
Something you associate with the cottage?
A farmhouse.
Let's have a look. First strike, I'm afraid. Dave.
Farm animals.
Let's have a look at farm animals. No. Second strike. Best family could steal back. Diane, you're our go-to person in time of crisis.
A thatched roof.
Mm. Like a nice English cottage.
Yes.
Let's see thatched.
Oh,
no, that's 3 strikes. Best family, Karen.
My mum's got a few flowers in her little cottage garden.
Nice. Andrew.
Veggie patch, grow your own stuff.
Robin.
I'm thinking a bit of a dirty weekend away at a nice cottage.
Oh, are you just? Hello. Kalia, wonderful options for you to choose.
Okay, I'm going to go with Kaz and I'm going to say flowers.
Flowers on the board for the steal. Does it give you more points? Yeah, it does. That's why they're the best family. Number 8. Small. They're small. Old. Oh.
Fireplace.
Or cheese. Righto, Scott family. What did you?
Oh, of course.
You discussed a few of those options.
No.
Okay. It's sincere on the front right now, Scott family. But this might help you. It's double points time. So Andrew, Anthony, let's do it.
Hey Andrew.
Hi Anthony. Good.
We surveyed 100 people, and the top 5 answers are on the board. Which museum exhibit would be the scariest at night? Yes, Andrew.
The Egyptian scene with the mummies coming out.
Let's have a look. Yeah, oh, nearly the top answer, Anthony.
A zombie museum.
That's obviously an historical museum. Yeah, like
Walking
through...
Dead,
yeah,
like that.
Yeah, okay. Let's have a look. No, afraid not. Pass or play. We're going to play. Imagine a school excursion to a zombie museum. Tracing through the history of zombies. Karen, which museum would be the scariest at night?
Well, I'm pretty short and I think dinosaurs are really tall, and I'd really struggle with the height of a dinosaur.
It'll freak at night time.
Yep.
Dinosaurs!
Beautiful.
Which museum exhibit would be scariest at night?
Ooh. I'm just going to say animals.
An animal one. That's, yeah. That's not bad.
Yeah.
Whoa! Robin.
She stole mine. She stole mine.
Oh, my goodness.
OK. There's
a lot of treachery on this team. Which museum exhibit would be scariest at night?
OK, a little more specific.
Yep.
Let's go with the cats, the big cats.
The cats.
Stuffed cats.
Mm, yeah. Stuffed. Grant, they're stuffed, those cats. First strike. Andrew.
The cavemen exhibit. They're going to come out with their clubs and start beating you over.
Yeah. Cavemen, says Andrew. Second strike. Scots could steal back here, so have a little thinkaroo over there, team.
What about a war exhibit?
Yeah, I see what you mean. It's kind of aggressive, isn't it? What about wartime? Three strikes, best family, over to the Scots. Get some points back in this double point round. Rachel, what would you say? Party!
That's not scary. Some of them are.
The Mona Lisa.
Ooh,
following you around the room?
The eyes that, yeah, supposedly follow you around the room. Anthony?
I'd say like a haunted house, ghost sort of thing.
Yep, cool.
Diane? I'm going ghosts.
Ghosts? A ghost exhibit? Dave?
Well, I think it'd be a ghost.
A ghost exhibit in the museum.
In a museum? Oh, I missed that part of the question.
Let's see if Scott's right. No, Scott's family are not. The points go to the best family. Takes them 270 remaining answers. Skeletons. Oh, wax museum. They even made a horror movie about it with Paris Hilton in it. It was terrible. If you're loving Family Feud right now, then you're going to really love 10 Play, where you can catch all the highlights and the fun bits that can't fit into our show on air. And you can also play along at home with our official Family Feud game. Head to 10 Play and look up Family Feud. All the details are there. Triple points time right here. Stick around on the Feud. Champs are sitting on 270 right now, and the Scott family, who it's their first night here tonight, so they're a little fragile, they're new to this, and it's zero right now, but this could help, because right now it's the family who gets to 300 points in this round could win $10,000. And while that might sound a little unlikely, Scott's, this is what could fix it. Triple points. That's what we're doing right now. Karen, Rachel, let's do it. We surveyed 100 people and the top six answers are on the board. If you won Tats Lotto, what's the first thing you'd buy? Rachel.
Holiday.
Yep. Ooh, not the top answer.
I'd have to buy Andrew a new car.
A new car! That's a lot of the first thing you'd buy, Carly?
A house.
Why wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Show me house on the board. Yeah. Takes a lot to make you smile, Robin,
she
but you know what?
Stealing my answers.
Stop complaining about your fellow teammates.
You know I love her. I still love her.
What would you buy if you won Tats Lotto? First thing?
I would definitely go on a shopping spree.
Yeah, you just unload in the shops.
Let's go.
First strike. Andrew?
I don't have one of these things and I can't swim, but I would probably want to buy a boat.
Yeah. That sounds like something I would want to do.
It's just a small little one.
Yeah, give me a boat. Second strike. Scots, here is possibly the chance you've been looking for. So think of an option. Karen, you can stop them though.
I go clothes shopping.
Clothes shopping. Show me clothes. Three strikes, best. Wow, this could get you guys right back in the game. All we need is one half-decent answer. Rachel.
Party?
Yes! You have a is that your real answer?
Yes! Yeah. Yeah.
Hi, Australia, I'm Rachel and I say party for everything. Yay! Anthony.
Not me personally, but jewellery.
You would buy some? Yeah, of course you would. You're trying to think what 100 Australians would say.
Yeah. Is that,
yeah, nice. Diane?
Just a small aeroplane would do me.
You're a classy lady, Diane. Where would you be going, per se?
Oh, I'd just go to Queensland 1 week, maybe...
Just land on the top of Everest. Just park it there, boss. Dave.
It's all up to me again, is it?
This will get you back in the game if you can just get one of those three remaining answers. What is it?
Well, I'd like to be generous and buy gifts for people.
You would buy people gifts. Mm. If you won Tats Lotto, what's the first thing you'd buy? You'd buy people gifts. Do we like that? Yeah. The Scots need it. Let's see if it's there. No, it's not, I'm afraid. Good try, Scots. The best family continue their winning streak. Number six. Here we are, Dave. You buy more tickets. A plane ticket. Food. You were close, Diane.
You were.
Diane's going, food? Who would bother doing that? Did you have fun, Scots?
Had fun.
It was a little bit of a party, Rachel. Just not quite the happy ending that we were hoping for.
We can celebrate losing.
Yeah, that's true. You know what? You will be going home with this little gift. Welcome back. It's Fast Money time. Let's see if the best family can now win some cash. You guys are playing so well, except when it comes to Fast Money time. So we can turn that around now, can't we?
We can.
Righto. Now, if you and Robin get 200 points or more between you, you'll win $10,000. You know that. Robin is now in our soundproof booth and can't hear your answers because she's just... silently running. I'm run singing. I'm going to ask you five questions. I'm going to give you 20 seconds to answer, OK? Now, if you pass, we'll come back at this time. And the clock starts at the end of the very first question. So, you set?
Set.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Best of luck.
Thank you.
Tell me someone who always has something for you to do.
Work, my boss.
Give me a reason a husband might be sleeping on the couch.
Can't go to bed.
Name a food you know is bad for you, but you eat it anyway.
Chocolate.
Name something people sell on the side of the road.
Fruit.
Name something that's ruined if it's left out in the sun too long.
Fruit.
I think you just got it in there. Fruit was the answer. Well done. Ooh. It's so tight, isn't it?
It is.
Tell me someone who has always has something for you to do. You said. The boss. Mr. Bossman does. Yep. Survey says. 30. Nice. Great job. Good start. Give you a reason a husband might be sleeping on the couch. You said. He can't go to bed. So therefore he would be in another location, i.e. the couch. Survey says.
Or on night shift.
Or on night shift. Not a bad answer. Unfortunately, bad result. Give me a food you know is bad for you, but you eat it anyway. You said. Chocolate. Survey says 34. That's nice. Name something people sell on the side of the road. You said sell fruit on the side of the road. Just fresh bananas, latest watermelons, apples, whatever's going, whatever's in season. Survey says 23. We're closing in on the 100. That's what we need to do. Name something that's ruined if it's left out the sun too long. That one came to you pretty easily because you just kind of said something like fruit. So let's go with fruit. Fruit. I feel good that that's like a good answer that might have a high number. Let's hope it gets us close to the 100, hey?
Hopefully.
Survey says... Hello! Okay, back to family. To the boy. Than last night.
Good.
You only need hard.
You only need 73 points to get $10,000. So she shot past the 100 mark, which is excellent. That's great news for you. I'm going to ask you the same five questions. You're the second player and it's a little harder. So I'll give you an extra 5 seconds, okay? Now, if you pass in a question, we'll come back at this time. And if you repeat an answer that's already there, you'll hear this sound and it'll ask you to try again. Can we remind everybody of Karen's answers and 25 seconds on the clock too, please? The time starts from the end of the first question. Good luck. Tell me someone who always has something for you to do.
A teacher.
Give me a reason a husband might be sleeping on the couch.
Had a late night.
Name a food you know is bad for you, but you eat it anyway.
Chocolate.
Try again.
Lollies.
Name something people sell on the side of the road.
Clothes.
Name something that's ruined if it's left out in the sun too long.
Food.
Cool, yes. I had to think for a second there. You played well. Let's go. Ooh. Is it better to go first or second?
Neither.
Tell me something, someone who always has something for you to do. You said, teacher, survey says, six. Mother was the top answer.
Should know that.
So we need 67. Give me a reason a husband might be sleeping on the couch. You said, late nights. This doesn't work out for you. You might be sleeping on the couch yourself. Survey says, seven. You're in trouble or you've had an argument was the top answer. We need 60 now for 10,000. Name a food you know is bad for you but you eat it anyway. You said lollies. That feels like a good answer. Survey says... Little do I know. Chocolate was the top answer. That was Karen's. So we need 60 now for 10,000. Name something people sell on the side of the road. You said clothes. No, shaking your head. No, not a good answer. No. Survey says... This turned out to be a horror round for you guys.
Yeah, thanks.
Name something that's ruined if it's left out the sun too long, you said. Food is... That feels pretty cool. The survey says... 18. Righto. Now, fruit was the top answer. Karen got that. Robin, so sorry. Good try. Not $10,000, but they do get $10 for every fast money point. They'll be back again. Another shot of 10,000. Stick around. Project's coming up now. News for all the family. I'm Grant Daniel. Good night, Australia.